Buckleys are a family band who hail from the Byron Bay area on the east coast of Australia. The three siblings have been playing music for as long as they can remember. Now, after two major hit singles in their homeland, they're on the verge of international success after recording their debut album. I'm Stormy Warren, inviting you to come with me to Sound Emporium Studios in Nashville, Tennessee, to meet the Buckleys.
Well, Molly, Sarah, and Lachlan, welcome to Nashville. You're no strangers to Nashville, but this is the first time you guys actually get to sit in the recording studio putting the tracks down to your debut album.
I know, it's pretty amazing, pretty exciting.
So how many instruments do you guys play?
I play guitar and sing and piano. Actually, we have a piano song on the album, which is really cool, because I've been writing a lot on piano lately.
I do like harmonies with Sarah, mandolin, organ. I'm starting to bring the organ and piano. Yeah, I love bringing in different instruments to play live. Like, I'm thinking about bringing violin in again. I used to do it when I was younger, like wagon wheel and stuff. Yeah, maybe. But yeah, just kind of constantly. Yeah, exactly.
I'm just electric guitar and slide guitar.
We grew up in like a musical family, so we always jammed, and like dad's a musician, so being at his gigs and just being around musicians all the time and songwriters. So we always did it.
Always playing like in the house without the whole family.
I was brought up on the Blues Brothers as well as lots of other stuff, but we were taught that three chord style piano. So, Sweet Home Chicago, probably the first song they all learned. What do you reckon, Sharon? well, come on, baby, don't you wanna go? Come on,
baby, don't you wanna go? Better that same old place, Sweet Home Chicago.
Anyways, let's just leave it at that.
Now, your dad being a drummer, obviously he didn't mind you playing music, but was he also a little cautious about watching his babies dive into this?
Well, he was in the like 80s rock scene, so I think country music came in, like he introduced us to country music because it's probably a little
safer.
More wholesome and safer than rock and roll. So that's probably why like Patsy Cline was a massive influence on me when I was growing up, and he really pushed us in that direction, just listening to music.
From as young as you can remember, music was a part of your life?
Yeah, I mean just being around like great musicians, our guitar teacher who we just jammed with, James T from Canned Heat, going up the country, he taught us the blues, and so that's where, there we go. Go for it, Tommy.
Here? Yes, you go. Now down two. Country, you got the traditional country, you got modern country, you got it all woven together.
And then rock and then funk.
But when you started, you guys were, 2011, right?
Around about 2011, Tamworth Country Music Festival. Have you been to that one?
Oh, yeah.
Maybe?
Mullumbimby, a town where we lived at, was there was a lot of doof parties around there, and being a 1980s rock and roller, I didn't like the kind of vibe of the doof parties, and I could see that the posters on the streets was influencing the kids. So I thought, what's the furthest place from a bush doof in Mullumbimby I can get the kids? So I thought, busking at the Tamworth Country Music Festival.
Another notch. This party ain't for shrinking.
What are you getting ready for?
Our first time busking, and I have no idea what to wear.
But when you start busking in Tamworth, you are entered into the Tamworth Country Music Festival busking competition.
And you didn't know this at the time?
We didn't know, but then we ended up coming top 10.
Dad got a call and said, the kids need to come play on the main stage.
Haven't had any rehearsals, but we just ran through two songs, so.
What about in the soundcheck? What are you doing? One song or two?
I don't know.
It's one song. I don't know, I have to ask.
I think we're doing one song in the soundcheck? I don't know.
Reality setting in right now, isn't it?
Totally. I mean, it's just amazing. It's everything kind of that we've been working towards since we started.
There's a shotgun here and you've been trying to make me disappear. And now I'm gone.
Well, my life goals, I want to become a member of the Grand Ole Opry. I would like to play in the CMA Festival in Nashville and perform in Nashville. I want to play in Nashville by the time I'm 16 years old.
So take me back. I know the story exists and you kind of touched on it there, but I want to go all the way back to when did the decision between you two happen where you said, we need to save money, we're going to Nashville?
Well, it's just, again, like we were just bought up with this stuff. So it was kind of Nashville was always the music city and just the place to be if you wanted to.
That's why we're all here.
Music.
Yeah,
exactly.
Totally.
Exactly. And so like playing at Tamworth Country Music Festival, everyone's always like, Nashville. To like, okay, well, we have to get to Nashville, like, if we want to do this.
Back then, I'm like, oh, yeah, okay, yeah, whatever, you know, where am I going to find all this money for six people to travel to Nashville?
So we just, like, got a jar. Yeah. Like, okay, put in all our money into this jar.
Like, yeah. All of it.
They wanted to come to Nashville, you wanted a new guitar.
Yeah. So we just, like, kept putting money into this jar, put it in the bank, busking wherever we could.
Like, Christmas
doing
money.
Chores.
Like, oh, our aunties would be like, oh, like, here's some money, but can you maybe, like, spend it on something like else that you want? I'm like, yeah. Sorry, it's in the tin jar.
They saved it up. Everything went into that tin.
Hey guys, so we are at the airport.
We're on our way to Nashville.
Nashville.
And we have 16 pieces of luggage.
Look at it.
Well, our first trip we came here, we played at Douglas Corner. And we met this wonderful woman named Debbie Throckmorton. And she kind of took us under her wing. She's like our fairy god sister, mother.
I was working in the office at Douglas Corner at the time. And they sent in just a thing to see if they could play there. And I listened to it, and then I begged Mervin to let them come play. He was like, okay, yeah. So they came and played, and I just fell in love with them from the second I heard them.
You've seen every aspect of this business. You know what to look for. You know what feels right. You know what your gut says. What was it about the Buckleys that struck you?
Their voices. I mean, of course, that was the start. I just said, I want to write every song with you. Let's do this.
My name's Sarah, this is my sister Molly and my brother Lachlan. And
we're super excited to be here in Nashville. We're playing a few shows.
Nashville, what you thought it would be?
It's one of those things that's like so surreal. Just like, oh yeah, it's awesome music city, but then there's so much more to it as well.
You said 3 years you've been up here writing, and what have you learned in the process?
The world of songwriting is something that I kind of knew existed a little bit, but wasn't really sure what it was. Like, I didn't know what a publishing deal was when I first got here. We're so lucky to have written, or I am anyway, as well, to have written with these people that we've grown up listening to their songs, like Jennifer Hansen, big one, Marty Dodson, Emily Shackleton, just, yeah, we love all of their music. And for, but for me, it was more inspiring, just like, wow, I want to like work and get to that level eventually, one day, hopefully.
One of the Buckleys' great friends and supporters in Nashville is famous Australian expat and Grammy-nominated producer Mark Moffat.
She was rattling off the names, everything from Bruce Chanel to Throckmorton. Right, yeah. It's like, are you kidding? Kelly Bannon?
Yeah. Phil Barton, who you know is a pretty amazing Australian writer, he made the comment, you know, because of the way she was introduced and because of her talents, she's writing with people it took him 6 years to get through.
Exactly.
You know, and that's amazing.
Yeah, now we are off to go write with Braith and Debbie out in Franklin.
Phil Barton, king songwriter, the dual citizen of Australia and the US, blazing trails for artists like the Buckleys.
I went to university up near Byron Bay, which you've been to Byron Bay, I know, and it just had that energy from that area too, which
is
excited
real.
Me. Because it's like, there's country, but you don't really think of Byron Bay associated with country, but somehow this little, you know, the hippie-ish vibe has come in.
Very creative.
And it just feels good. I mean, it's just a good feeling music.
Can't get you off of my mind 24/7 all day, all night. Yeah, you got me feeling something like Hollywood big screen.
Let's do the parallel. So you have Music City, which everybody says, and it's true, there is an energy, there's a vibration to this town that is absolutely real. I say the same thing about Byron Bay. Can you draw a parallel between the two? There's an energy in Byron Bay, there's an energy in they're completely different energies.
I know what you mean.
But what do you draw from each?
I mean, I think there's totally a buzz. Like when you're walking down the street, you just feel something different that you don't feel in other places. And the people are just, it's this different way of thinking about life, I think. Like it's not you're not taking the usual courses, I think. Whether that's good or bad, I don't know, but it's just what it is. And the creativity. Everywhere, it's like different forms of creativity.
Yeah,
but
Byron's really creative in that sense as well. So they're both creative towns and atmospheres.
And lots of creative people.
As soon as I met Sarah, I knew it was magic. And the first song we wrote was a song called Daydream with Kelly Bannon.
Which went number one in Australia.
One of Sarah's favorite songwriting partners is Chad Carlson, who is also the highly acclaimed producer of the Buckleys' debut album.
Daydream, it turned out to be a perfect launch pad for the Buckleys.
Well, we cut two. There was another one that we had written with Melissa, our friend, and then Daydream was with a Phil Barton song, which we all know and love, of course. And Greg Shaw, her manager at the time, suggested, well, folks, why don't you go cut both of them? And we all love Daydream, but we're like, let's just have a backup in case I do a bad job on Daydream and we need a backup. And luckily, we all did our jobs and did it well, and it was just magic from the start. I knew the first time I heard that song, I'm like, this is a big old song.
You know, what's funny about this, me working with the Buckleys, was I sat next to Mick Buckley, the Buckley father.
The patriarch.
At a wedding in Australia, a good friend of ours, Huey, that used to live, was a roommate with Keith Urban at one stage here in Nashville. So I went to this wedding one night and sat next to this guy, Mick Buckley, and And that's where it all started.
In early 2019, Dan Biddle, the chairman of the Country Music Association of Australia, brought the Buckleys to the attention of Chris Murphy, who was one of Australia's most successful global music entrepreneurs.
Phil had put me onto the band a few years ago.
I was working at Falls Festival, actually, and he called me when I was there. I was selling fish and chips at Falls Festival. And I get a call from Dan Biddle. I'm like, oh, hey, Dan. And he's like, oh, this Chris Murphy wants you guys to come over to the ranch and be available next Thursday. And so we were. Well, I don't know, we obviously made sure that we were.
Chris is a, I guess you could say, an idol of mine, having achieved so much with In Excess.
When In Excess broke, every A&R guy in America rang their Australian affiliate, whoever they were, and said, where's our In Excess? Mm. When the Buckleys break, the same thing will happen.
One of Chris's specialties is research. Find out the ins and outs of what you're working on. And so I kind of applied that technique when looking at who is someone that can make a difference to the Australian country music industry and help take a band from, in this case, Byron Bay to the world.
When Dan brought them over, my wife cooked one of her delicacies, which is hot dogs and chips and chocolate milkshakes. And we all sat down, that's how we met each other. I spent 3 hours with them. And within that 3 hours, I was just captivated.
The way he thinks is very similar to the way we think in terms of, just very global. It's kind of insane how on the same wavelength and on the same page we are, because we've always been fighting against that kind of structure of how you're supposed to do things and done the opposite. But Chris believes in the same things that we do. So it's just amazing that we've ended up with him and Caroline and Petrol Records, who are, I don't know, they're just the perfect fit for us.
There are artists that have tenacity and there are artists that have talent, and the Buckleys have both. That's where Chris comes in.
How do you harness a trio that is so inspired by so many different impacts of music? I mean, you're talking 50s all the way to current day modern country and rock and pop and EDM and anything that's out there, they're influenced by. How do you harness that to create a signature sound?
For me, I think before this started, when she sent me this whole Dropbox, right? Like, this Dropbox is like 40 songs, and they're all different and they're all great. But I think when we talked, I said, okay, let's treat it like they're small, great songs, but let's think of the Buckleys are hippie country. Let's because their last video was very hippie and awesome. Like, and there's really, it's kind of who they are.
The Buckleys are hippie country. They are hippie country, and I love it.
The hippie country thing is unbelievable. Then Sarah, and I think it's Phil Gane, go off and write a song called Woodstock, which is about a young person looking back at Woodstock. You haven't heard this song,
no.
Have you? And I go, this is a dream come true.
Even if it's a little bit Motown, even if it's a little bit rock, that's fine, as long as it fits in the genre.
Interestingly, Nashville is known as Music City, and Tamworth, known as the country music capital of Australia, were joined as sister cities in 2013 in a ceremony held at the Country Music Hall of Fame in downtown Nashville. Guest of honor on that day was one of the stars of the hit Nashville TV series, Australia's own Claire Bowen.
It's great to see these two fantastic cities, Tamworth and Nashville, joining together as sisters, and I am sure making beautiful music together in the future.
Just like we celebrate all things country music, particularly during CMA Music Fest, which is going on all around us this week, Tamworth is home to the largest country music festival in the Southern Hemisphere.
During the festival, the high point is the Golden Guitars, Australia's most prestigious country music awards. While in Nashville late last year, the Buckleys took a break from recording their debut album to watch the Golden Guitar Award nominations streaming live from Australia.
Qantas New Talent of the Year. And the finalists are... The
Big thank you to everyone for the nominations. This is such an honor and a dream come true. Thank you, Australia.
After the nominations, the Country Music Association of Australia asked the Buckleys to perform live on that night.
So wild. It's, you know, we have so many memories in Tamworth, dream, like literally like saying, oh, imagine if we ever got nominated for a Golden Guitar. Imagine if we ever, I don't even think we ever even said, imagine if we played at the Golden Guitars.
Yeah, we used to busk here quite a bit when back in the day. back in about 2011, I think it was. I think I was about 12, Molly would have been a bit younger, and Lachlan in the middle of us. Yeah, so it's super cool to be back.
We have the guitar case out here raising some money for the bushfires and all the victims affected by it. But we're going to play a few songs. It'll be coming out soon, so stay tuned for it. He's gonna come up and play a song with us. You guys all know him. Mr. Lee Carnegie is here.
I can't tell you how happy I am to be here. This band, Australia, look out for this band. World, look out for this band, the Buckleys. We can all be very, very proud of them for what they've done already and what they're about to do.
Thank you, Lee. What a legend.
Well, there was a huge storm rolling into Tamworth, and lightning was striking all around us. And I'm not talking about the physical lightning, I'm talking about the Buckleys, because they were on stage in front of a packed out crowd at the Long Yard. And I got to actually sing a song with the guys, and this is the first time I've ever performed with them. The feeling that I had, it was a feeling that I remember I experienced when I first saw Keith Urban busking in Peel Street in Tamworth, and then that time when he won the Star Maker Award. And when I saw the Buckleys last night, I got the same feeling. They're bringing something new to country music.
You know, everyone keeps asking me, where, how come they look like rock stars already?
The Buckleys, ladies and gentlemen.
Hello, how are you? You've had a big year, first nomination tonight.
Yes, absolutely, our very first nomination, so crazy.
You guys look fantastic, I love the outfits. You're just, yeah, fantastic, and what a breath of fresh air.
Yeah, thank you so much.
We are here at the Golden Guitar Awards. Everyone looks so beautiful.
At the 2020 Toyota Golden Guitar Awards, please welcome to the stage, Best New Talent nominees, the Buckleys.
I can't get you off of my mind, 24/7 all day, all night. Yeah, you got me feeling something like Hollywood big screen on cloud nine. Got my pulse racing like a 747. Only place I'm going is in your direction. I can't even tell you why, so I'm not gonna even try. Been walking these back streets of my head. Crazy, you're in my heartbeat, you're making
just love how authentic it is, and I love how organic it all has been, and I love that there's respect for the past music, and there's still breaking ground sonically.
They're all just committed to being this happy family, and that's hard to find too, as families that can work together, and they're just all about each other and love each other, and we're raised up right and just do incredible music.
The Buckleys are a young Australian band taking on the world with the imminent release of their debut album. And this is just the beginning.
Where are we going?
Apparently Sugar Beach Ranch is about 500 meters up the road.
Who booked this rich chick's party anyway?
Guys, we go on tour in a month. We need the money.
Howdy, y'all. You must be the Buckleys. Welcome to Sugar Beach Ranch.
I got change burning in my pocket. It goes jingle, 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 and I kinda like it. How the dreams ready to rock it. We gon' bullshit, bullshit, father.
Should.